Welcome to this Bend the Curve webcast. Bend the Curve is an educational campaign developed by NEHI with support from the WellPoint Foundation, aimed at providing healthcare leaders with actionable ways to reduce spending without impacting quality in an effort to create high-value healthcare. The campaign covers 7 critical areas of wasteful healthcare spending and seeks to provide healthcare professionals with data to identify where costs can be reduced and recommendations for actionable solutions. In this webcast, we'll be looking at the problem of hospital admissions due to ambulatory care-sensitive conditions. Targeting the $31 billion spent annually on hospital admissions due to ambulatory care-sensitive conditions, or ACSCs, requires building on proven practices and implementing policy actions that target the root causes of the problem. These include increasing access to primary care and community health centers, reducing patient travel time, increasing Medicaid re-enrollment time, and expanding the Medicaid Managed Care Program, among others. But before we talk about the tools healthcare leaders can utilize to decrease hospital admissions for ACSCs, we first have to talk about what they actually are, as they sound confusing, but are really pretty simple to understand. Ambulatory care-sensitive conditions are conditions which, through preventative care and appropriate treatment, should not cause a patient to be hospitalized. A few of the most common and well-known examples of ACSCs include asthma, diabetes, COPD, hypertension, congestive heart failure, and bacterial pneumonia. To give you an idea of the size and scope of this issue, between 1994 and 2003, hospital admissions rates increased for 5 ambulatory care-sensitive conditions: hypertension, diabetes, COPD, bacterial pneumonia, and urinary tract infections, or UTIs. In addition, between 1999 and 2007, among adults on Medicaid, the ED visit rate for ambulatory care-sensitive conditions per 1,000 enrollees increased from 66.4 to 83.9, a percentage increase of over 25%. Hospital admissions due to ambulatory care-sensitive conditions end up costing the healthcare system a significant amount of money each year. In 2006, it was approximately $31 billion in hospital costs alone. Furthermore, not all ambulatory care-sensitive conditions are equal, at least not from the point of view of how much they cost the healthcare system. In 2006, congestive heart failure and bacterial pneumonia accounted for over half of the total hospital costs, more than $8 billion and about $7 billion respectively, for all preventable hospitalizations. Just about anyone can suffer from an ambulatory care-sensitive condition, such as asthma or diabetes, and anyone who suffers from such a condition could end up being hospitalized for it. With that being said, there are a number of specific groups who are especially at risk for ambulatory care-sensitive conditions. For example, those receiving Medicaid and the uninsured have been shown to have higher ACSC hospitalization rates than insured individuals, as have individuals who have difficulty accessing care. In addition, racial and ethnic minorities and individuals with low socioeconomic status are more likely than non-minorities and individuals of higher socioeconomic status to be hospitalized due to ACSCs. Decreasing hospital admissions for ambulatory care-sensitive conditions requires building on a coordinated set of proven practices in the field, coupled with policy actions in both the private and public sectors. The following slides talk a bit more about how these proven practices and policy actions can address this healthcare problem. One proven way of decreasing hospital admissions for ambulatory care-sensitive conditions represents a renewed emphasis on community care, as a recent study found that among low-income and elderly patients in medically underserved areas, those with access to a federally qualified community health center had 21% fewer preventable hospitalizations than those without access. Researchers have also recently found that something as simple as reducing the amount of time it takes a patient to get to the provider can have an effect on ACSC hospital admissions, as patients in the Veterans Administration who traveled less than 30 minutes to their nearest provider had fewer ACSC hospitalizations than those with longer trips. A number of states have been making innovative changes to their Medicaid enrollment policies. California, for example, extended the eligibility redetermination period from 3 to 12 months, resulting in 3,060 fewer ambulatory care-sensitive hospitalizations in the first year alone among children and almost a $17 million reduction in hospitalization costs. Medicaid managed care programs have also been an effective way to decrease hospital admissions for ACSCs, as individuals covered by a mandatory Medicaid managed care program had a 33% lower rate of ACSC hospitalizations compared to Medicaid fee-for-service recipients. Earlier, we talked about the importance of a renewed emphasis on community care. Solutions to the issue of ambulatory care-sensitive conditions must also emphasize the importance of primary care. Increasing physician supply by 40.2 physicians per 100,000 population has been shown to reduce the ambulatory care sensitive hospitalization rate by 14% for children, 7% for 18 to 39 year olds, and 8% for 40 to 64 year olds. Furthermore, policy action should focus on expanding affordable and comprehensive health coverage to the uninsured, underinsured, Medicaid-insured, and medically underserved populations. A final promising way to decrease hospital admissions for ambulatory care-sensitive conditions we've identified relates to policy actions that can improve chronic disease management. A two-pronged approach to chronic disease management, focusing on education and care coordination, is effective. Educational interventions for patients with asthma have been shown to reduce the risk of hospitalization by 36 to 43%. And discharge planning plus post-discharge support for patients with heart failure has been shown to reduce hospital readmissions for this population by about 25% on average. That brings us to the end of this Bend the Curve webcast. We hope that the webcast has been enjoyable and informative. If you'd like a copy of this presentation in PowerPoint form, or you'd like to learn more about this or any of the other Bend the Curve topics, please visit the website at www.nehi.net/bendthecurve. On the website, you'll find the Healthcare Leader's Guide to High-Value Healthcare, policy briefs, PowerPoint presentations, and more of these webcasts. We encourage you to use these tools to educate your colleagues, as well as to identify and implement successful solutions aimed at addressing the very real problem of healthcare waste in your organizations and communities. Thank you, and take care.